Warren Chanos at the University of Washington. But this, Joe lived with me for many years on and off, and I lived with him in Brooklyn for many years on and off. And he had one extraordinary habit, that he could not go to bed without an argument. Especially if he had a whiskey, one shot of whiskey, and he turned into what he used to call an Apache. You never won with Joe. But there was one poet, O'Brother, who reminded me so much of Joe. Because he wrote, in translation anyway, one of his poems starts out, "I'll sing no more songs," which is what he used to say at O'Donoghue's every night of the week. I'll give you a bit of it. "I'll sing no more songs. The pride of my country I sang through 40 long years of good rhyme without any avail. And no one cared even as much as the half of a hang for the song or the singer. So here's an end to the tale. If a person should think I complain and have not got a cause, let him bring his eyes here and take a good look at that hand. Let him say if a goose quill has calloused this poor pair of paws, or the spade that I grip on and dig with out there in the land. When the great ones were safe and renowned and were rooted and tough, though my mind went to them and took joy in the fortune of those and pride in their pride and their fame, they gave little enough, not as much as two boots for my feet or an old suit of clothes. I ask of the craftsman who fashioned the fly and the bird, of the champion whose passion will save me from death and time, the spirit who melts icy hearts with the wind of a word, that my people be worthy and get better singing than mine. I had hoped to live decent when Ireland was quit of her care, as a bailiff or steward perhaps in some house of degree. The end of my tale is old brogues and old breeches to wear. So I'll sing no more songs for the men who care nothing for me."
Oh, sad.